Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. Now we are going to talk about internal energy is a state function. Earlier for which we have got to know that work and heat, the both were path function. That means they were depending on the path. But now internal energy is known to be a state function. That means it depends on the state, initial state as well as the final state. So let us talk about it, how internal energy is said to be a state function. Let us do. So for that, what we are going to do is, we are going to consider a system at state A, that has been here, having a pressure, volume and internal energy represented as PA, VA and UA respectively. So this is the first state of a particular system that has a particular internal energy, pressure and volume. So, and this is a graph which has been made for pressure and volume for both. So the thing is, by changing the pressure and volume, because we are now concerned with the pressure, we can change the pressure and volume. And in this case, what happens is, by changing the pressure and volume at state A to PB, means we are changing the pressure which was initially at PA, and now we are being changing the pressure at PB and VB, that is for volume also, because volume and pressure, the both will change, because this is the graph which is which represents of pressure and volume. So in this case, what will happen if we have to convert or we have to change the pressure PA and VA to PB and VB respectively? So what will happen actually, but through path 1. So this is the path 1 through which we are performing the change. So the system is taken to the state B. Once we have made change from state A, that is we have changed the pressure as well as the volume. So this will led us to make a change or a final state where we could see the pressure has been changed to PB and the volume also has been changed to VB. So this is the first change that we have observed, but this is done through the path 1. So this is done through path 1 as we could see. So now moving towards the next one. So next one says that UB is the internal energy of the system at state B. So therefore delta UA is internal energy change to path A, sorry, path 1. So what does this mean actually? So internal energy of state A, it was being UA, but when we have changed it, the pressure as well as we have changed the volume from PA VA to PB VB, so what we have got to know that we have also found a change in the internal energy, that is from UA to UB. But this change in internal energy from UA to UB through path 1 can be represented as change in internal energy, that is delta UA, and this delta UA is the change in internal energy through path 1. So now this is basically the change in internal energy, as we could see, the change in internal energy, that is delta UA, that has been led from path from the state A to B. So that is what they are talking about. So now let's move on further and let us see what will happen next if we change from the final state to the initial state. So by changing the pressure and volume at state B back to PA and VA through path 2. So what they are now trying to say is, as suppose once what happens, we have changed PA to PA VA to PB VB. So this is the final state that we have observed. But suppose if we have to further make the change from like the initial one, so means we have to go back to the initial state. So what will happen, this PB and VB will come back to PA and VA, the state where A was being represented. But the path has now been changed. The path has been changed from, suppose, from path 2, as we could see. Earlier, A was going towards B, there where we have found this kind of change. And now what we are making the final state, that is B, to come towards back to the initial state, that is A. But they are now performing different path. So this path is represented by Roman number 2. So what will happen in this case? Let us observe that. So the system is back to the state A. So now delta UB is the internal energy change corresponding to path 2. So what has happened? Initially, what we have represented, that when the internal energy change that we have found from UA to UB, that kind of change in internal energy through path 1 was being represented by delta UA. But now what happens when we are performing the change from that is when we have pressure of PB and VB and the internal energy as UB, and we are going to perform the change from UB to UA. So in this case, again, they are performing, suppose if they are performing the path 2nd, and we could see that the change in internal energy would be represented as delta UB. This delta UB is just for the path 2, not for path A. So this, the both are being represented differently in this case, suppose. Now let us move on further things so that we could analyze what else we could find. So suppose if the magnitude of delta UA, that is the change in internal energy from A to B, and delta UB, that is change in internal energy from B to A through path 2, are not same. So the first, according to the first law of thermodynamics, this would be contradiction. How? Because internal energy is nothing but the energy that has been associated in the system, and the change, whatever the change would happen, the change would be the same. Suppose if they are not same, then what will happen? So what the amount of energy that has been left, where that energy has been gone? Is the energy destroyed? Or the kind of energy that has been created? No, energy cannot be destroyed and cannot be created. This is the first law of thermodynamics. And if they are saying that UA and UB are not same, then we could find a difference between them. And hence delta U can be represented as, suppose they are different. So delta U can be represented as delta U is equals to delta UA minus delta UB. So this would get a difference, but does it happen? Let us see in the further thing. So the difference in the internal energy, that is delta U, has a fixed value and will be independent on the path taken between the two states, that is A and B. So this clearly indicates that internal energy, the change in internal energy, doesn't depend on the path that it has undergone through that path. It will not depend on the path of A to B or B to A. It will depend on the initial and the final state of that particular system. That's the reason internal energy is said to be a state function. But there are more proofs also, so that we could analyze more that why internal energy is said to be a state function. So in this case, suppose I'm talking about this again, this delta U, change in internal energy of through path A and through path B, suppose the both are different. But this is not possible because any change will happen, suppose, because they are performing, they are coming back to the same state, that is from UA to UB or UB to UA. So that's the reason that the both are performing two different paths, but the value would be different. That would lead to, there will be a difference between the those two magnitudes of UA and delta UB. So that's the reason they are that would contradict the thermodynamic first law. So for a small instance, that's the reason delta U has a fixed value for a particular system, or whenever a change happens from A to B or B to A, whatever we say. So in this case, for a chemical reaction, what we observe is delta U is nothing but U of product minus U of reactant. Means the internal energy of a product minus internal energy of a reactant, that is what we calculate. Means we are calculating the internal energy of the product, what is the product and what will be the internal energy of the product, and we are calculating what would be the internal energy of the reactant. And when we are getting when we differentiate the both two, or when we subtract both two, then only we could find a change in internal energy. But we are not concerned with the path of it. That's the reason internal energy doesn't depend on the path, but depends on the state. So now let us move on further and let us make a final statement that what we have got to know by this. So now we could give a final statement that internal energy, that is U, is a state function. So this means that delta U depends only on the initial state and the final state, and is independent on the path. In other words, if we would say that delta U will be the same even if the change is brought differently. So what does this talks about is, suppose what happens if the same thing that we are going to talk about, where the thermodynamic first law has been contradicted. That is when delta U is equals to delta U of A minus delta U of B. Supposing the both are being different. So in that case, since that was been associated to the change in internal energy through the path, means that change, that is delta UA and delta UB, the both were the values that were depending on the path. And since the both were not same, so this indicates, suppose the both are not same, that this indicates that this is nullifying those thermodynamic first law. So this clearly indicates, suppose if that is not the option, then only the one option is left. Yes, it is a state function. It depends on the initial state and the final state, but it doesn't depend on the path of the reaction of the process where it happens. So this makes internal energy to be a state law. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have got to know more information about this. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.